Hello everyone, welcome to Endovision for You. In this video, we are going to discuss tricks for bone order and bone angle. Question regarding bone order, bone angle, bone length and as well as stability of molecule are asked frequently in CATE. So by knowing the tricks, you will easily solve that question and it will also save your time during examination. So let's start. First, let's discuss what is bond order. So bond order means half the difference between number of electron in bonding molecular orbital and number of electron in anti-bonding molecular orbital. And bond order is directly proportional to stability. That means higher the bond order, higher stability of the molecule. Suppose we have two molecules having bond order 2.5 and 3 respectively. That means the molecule having a bond order 3 is more stable as compared to the molecule having a bond order 2.5. And bond length is inversely proportional to bond order. That means if bond order is more, bond length is less. As we see, the bond order of 2.5 and 3, that means the molecule having a bond order 2.5 is high bond length as compared to a bond order and the bond order as compared to another molecule having a bond order 3. The bond order and bond length are inversely proportional, but bond order and stability are directly proportional. Now the question is, what if we get same bond order, then how we check the stability? So for checking the stability, we have to see the number of electron in anti-bonding molecular orbital. Less is the number of electron in anti-bonding molecular orbital, more is the stability of that molecule. So this is all about bond order. Now let's see trick to learn bond order. In left side we have number of electron, in right side we have bond order. You have to just remember, if the number of electron is 14, the bond order is 3. After 14 and before 14, just decreases the bond order by 0.5. like for 13 it is 2.5, for 12 it is 2, for 11 it is 1.5, for 10 it is 1. Similarly, for 15 it is 2.5, for 16 it is 2, for 17 1.5, and for 18 it is 1. To see how easily you can know the bond order of different molecule and how easily you can solve any question related to bond order and bond length and stability. Now let us see one question. This question is asked in GATE. And the question is, as predicted by molecular orbital theory, the bond order of NO+. And the option given are 3, 2, 1 and 1.5. So first we have to calculate number of electron for NO+. So number of electron for NO+ is 14. So we know if the number of electron are 14, then the bond order is 3. So the correct answer is A, that is 3. If you know the trick, you will easily solve that question. Now, let's see the trick to find bond order of polyatomic ion. Bond order of a polyatomic ion is number of resonating bond divided by number of resonating structure. To understand this, let us take two examples. First is CO3 minus 2. For calculating bond order, we have to draw its structure first. And now the question is, how do we know about resonating bond and resonating structure? So the trick is, for calculating resonating bond, you have to see the number of bond directly attached to the central atom. Like in case of CO3 minus 2, there are 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 bond are directly attached to central atom C, so there are 4 number of resonating bond. Now if we talk about resonating structure, for resonating structure we have to see number of atom surrounded by central atom. Like in CO3 minus 2, there are 1, 2, 3. 3 atoms that are surrounded by center atom. So number of resonating structure is 3. So we can easily calculate bond order as number of resonating bond divided by number of resonating structure, that is 4 by 3, and we get the answer 1.33. Now, next example is PO4 minus 3. And first we draw the structure. Now we have to calculate the number of resonating bond, and we know resonating bond means bond directly attached to center atom. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 bond are attached, and resonating structure 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 atoms are directly attached to the central atom. So the number of resonating structure are 4. So we get bond order as 5 by 4, that is 1.25. Now, after understanding the tricks for bond order, let's see the trick for bond ending. The first point is, first we have to check the hybridization of central atom. Like in case of if S character is more, bond angle is more. Like for SP, the bond angle is 180 degree. For SP2, bond angle is 120 degree. For SP3, bond angle is 109 degree 28 minutes. So, as S character is increasing, bond angle is also increasing. So first we have to check hybridization of central atom. Now, if hybridization is same, we have to check the lone pair. If lone pair is present on central atom, that means high the number of lone pair, low is the bond angle. Now the second point is clear. Now let's see third point. What if we get same hybridization and same number of lone pair in center atom? So there are two cases. First case is central atom is same but side atom are different, and second case is central atom is different but side atom are same. So for that we have to see first case. Let's take first case, that is central atom is same. Example is CoF2 and CoCl2. In this central atom Co is same but side atom F2 and Cl2 are different. So in that case, bond angle is directly proportional to size of side atom. Or side atom electronegativity is high, less is the bond angle. In case of CoF2 and CoCl2, fluorine is more electronegative. So we know if side atom electronegativity is high, less is the bond angle. For CoF2, bond angle is less because fluorine is more electronegative as compared to fluorine. Now the second case is central atom are different, the side atom are same. So that means the central atom electronegativity is high, more is the bond angle. Or we can say bond angle is inversely proportional to size of central atom. Like in case of PS3 and NS3, nitrogen is more electronegative than phosphorus. So central atom electronegativity is high, more is the bond angle. So that's why NS3 has high bond angle as compared to PH2. Now we have to see one question, that is we have to arrange the bond angle in terms of bond angle, correct order of bond angle, and the molecule given are CH4, NH3 and H2O. First we have to apply the first case, that is hybridization, but in that case all have same hybridization, that is SP3. So now we have to see second case, lone pair are present or not. As we see in the structure, there are no lone pair in CH4, there is one lone pair in NH3, there are two lone pair in H2. So high is the number of lone pair, low is the bond angle. So H2O is having a lowest bond angle, then NH3 and then CH4. So the correct option is C. CH4 is highest bond angle because no lone pair is present, then NH3 and then H2O. Now the second question, we have to arrange in correct order of bond angle, and the molecule given are OF2, OCl2 and H2O. So first we have to check hybridization. All will have same hybridization, that is SP3. Then we have to check lone pair. All have two lone pair. Now this is the third part, that is if the molecule is having same hybridization and same lone pair, then we have to check either the same side atom or the same central atom. But in this case, we have same central atom, that is O. So that means side atom electronegativity is high, smaller is the bond angle. So in that case, in OF2 we have fluorine, that is more electronegativity than, more electronegative than oxygen and fluorine. That means it has smaller bond angle. So OF2 is smaller. After that, we can say OCl2, because Cl is more electronegative than hydrogen. But here is an exception, because OCl2 contains two Cl group, as you see in the structure, and these Cl group are so bulky, they repel each other and the bond angle gets increased. So the correct option is option B, that is OCl2's highest bond angle as compared to H2O and OF2. Now this is one MSQ which has same bond order as N2, and the option given as CN, CO, NO positive and O2. We can easily solve this question by using the trick, as we already explained. The trick is N2 have 14 electrons, so that means bond order is 3. So we have to calculate the number of electrons of the given option. For CN, the number of electrons is 13. For CO, number of electrons is 14. For NO+, number of electrons is 14. For O2, number of electrons is 16. We know for B and C option, we get number of electrons 14, so that means they have same bond order as N2, that is 3. Now, next question is asked in Gate Excel 2017, and the question says that decreasing order of bond length for O2, B2, N2, and C2. So we have to check the bond length order. First, we have to calculate bond order, because we know bond order is inversely proportional to bond length. For that, we have to calculate number of electrons. For O2, number of electrons is 16 and bond order is 2. For B2, number of electrons is 10 and bond order is 1. For N2, number of electrons is 14 and bond order is 3. And for C2, number of electrons is 12, bond order is 2. Now we know high is the bond order, less is the bond length. And more low is the bond order, high is the bond length. So for B2, bond order is 1, that is lowest. It is having the highest bond length. So the highest bond length is for B2. So the either option A or B or D should be correct. Now N2 is having a bond order 3, that is highest bond order. So it has lowest bond length. Now we can see in option B, N2's lowest bond length, so we can easily eliminate other options. So the correct option is option B, that is C2 is highest bond length, then C2, then O2, and then N2. Thank you. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe to this channel.